The provincial government of Albay continues to urge evacuees living outside of Mayon Volcano's 6-kilometer permanent danger zone to return to their homes. This despite the Mayon Volcano's increased activity. Our very own Jose Carretero now joins us with that story. Jose, what more can you tell us?
Good afternoon, Carmina. Albay Governor Edsel Greco Lagman inspected yesterday the evacuation centers in Albay. He also checked on the status of the aid in form of food packs given by United Arab Emirates and China. Lagman said the distribution of the aid will be prorated to ensure that everyone will get the aid. Meanwhile, Lagman said the provincial government is now planning for post-disaster response, especially to displaced economies due to the volcano's unrest. Meanwhile, more than 20,000 individuals are still in the evacuation centers. Governor Lagman said it would be better if those residents living outside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone to decamp. Most of the evacuees from Santo Domingo, Albay, opted to stay at the evacuation centers despite the decampment order by Mayor June Aguas. They say they're still afraid of the volcano. That's why they chose to stay in the evacuation center. Governor Lagman, however, assures evacuees who return to their houses would still be given aid as they were considered economically displaced. Meanwhile, Carmina, all-terrain vehicle or ATV operators in Legazpi City have asked permission from the local government unit to allow them to operate as many tourists flock to Albay to witness the lava flow. Saril Chan, one of the ATV operators in Legazpi City, said they have already created new ATV trails away from the danger zone so tourists can enjoy their visit in Albay. The ATV operation in Albay was suspended after state volcanologists raised the alert level of Mayon Volcano to 3. Alert level 3 remains over Mayon Volcano with 107 volcanic earthquakes recorded. Carmina.
A farmers group now warns of soaring rice prices due to the potential adverse effect of the El Nino phenomenon. Our very own Lady Vicentia reports.
Dry spells and drought may occur in 38 Philippine provinces by year-end as an effect of the El Nino phenomenon. But State Weather Bureau Pag-asa clarified that the impact of El Nino will not be the same throughout the country. Pag-asa is expected to provide a list and more details on what to expect within the week. But it says 36 provinces can potentially experience dry spells, while meteorological drought is possible in 2 provinces.
Sinabi po natin dry spell, at least 2 buwan na sobrang more than 60% ang reduction sa tubig ulan, or 3 buwan na sunod-sunod na may reduction ng 41 to 60% ang reduction sa tubig ulan. And then yung kapag sinabi po natin meteorological drought, 3 buwan na sunod-sunod na around more than 60% ang reduction sa tubig ulan, o 5 buwan na sunod-sunod na may reduction ng mga around 21 to 60% reduction sa tubig ulan.
Farmers Group Federation of Free Farmers Cooperatives Incorporated predicts a spike in rice prices if local production will be affected by El Nino. But this early price monitoring of the Agriculture Department shows an increase in retail prices in Metro Manila. The DA says some of the factors in play are high palay prices reaching 20 to 23 pesos and the lack of drying facilities, which is critical during the rainy season.
Hindi naman po lahat ng mga areas ay merong recirculating rice dryer, no? So definitely, ang presyo po kasi ng ating basang palay at ang tuyo ay magkaiba. Siyempre, mas gusto po natin na naibibenta ng ating magsasakan na tuyo ang kanilang palay para mas maganda ang presyo.
FFFCI echoed the DA's earlier projection that some rice-producing areas might benefit from the El Nino event as the onset of dry episodes is expected to happen on the main harvest season. But the group is worried if there will be enough buffer stock for 2024.
Ang problema natin, yung end-of-the-year stocks na ipapasa natin sa 2024. Sa tingin ko, yung dry season crop during the first semester of 2024, yun yung malaking epekto ng El Nino. Pagdating natin ng lean months next year, we will have relatively low stocks.
Montemayor added that pressures in the global market will also come into play for retail rice prices as the rest of Asia is also expected to feel the impact of El Nino, including top rice exporters like Vietnam. The International Rice Research Institute has been promoting the use of drought-tolerant rice varieties such as Sahod Ulan, which are used in rain-fed lowland farms. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.
A hospitals group fears it will be even harder for healthcare workers to receive their pandemic benefits once the state of public health emergency in the Philippines is officially lifted. The Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines says up to now, many of their members have yet to receive their allowances mandated by law. It calls on government to have a clear directive on the matter.
Pag inalis po natin yung state of public emergency, ano mangyayari po do sa mga privileges, benefits po healthcare workers? Yan po may bibigay pa kasi yung law natin na on HEA, during a state of emergency lang po yun. Naiipit po yung pondo sa mga CHD, tinatawag natin regional offices ng Department of Health. Sila po nagre-require sa mga hospitals na mag-submit ng different documentation. Ang role po ng hospital yan, parang conduit lang. Tatanggapin nila yung pera, then they will distribute.
For Dr. Medicar Limpin, Health Secretary Ted Herbosa's proposal to lift the public health emergency status will just be a mere formality.
Na-lift na kasi siya. Kasi di ba yung public health emergency natin wasn't extended noong December. It was basically lifted. It sent message then even to the lalong-lalo na sa private sector, no? Lalong-lalo na doon sa business community na wala na tayo doon sa public health emergency.
A private firm offers a free review program for nursing graduates to help fill thousands of vacancies in government hospitals. Let's hear more from Willard Chang.
A review center chain is offering a free review program for nursing graduates currently working in public and private hospitals and hoping to pass the next board exams in November. 10,000 slots will be opened nationwide with the help of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Quezon City.
We are giving full review to all nurses who graduated but are not yet passers, be in government or private sector, basta't employed sila. Bakit sila yung priority namin? Kasi nandun na sila. They're already there and they are just waiting for their chance to pass.
Health Secretary Teodoro Herbosa supports the move, which aims to help fill up more than 4,000 nursing vacancies in government hospitals.
Ilan yung bakante ko? 4,500. Kung napapasa ni Carl yung 90% nun, may nurses na kagad akong. So imagine the supply side na change. Talagang meron kagad akong nurses to put in government.
Herbosa also plans to form a National Nursing Advisory Council and appoint a Chief Nursing Officer with the rank of Undersecretary. The council will be composed of representatives from the public and private sector and is expected to tackle issues facing the nursing profession, including migration.
We'll get the heads of the Philippine Nurses Association, the Philippine Board of Nursing, the head of ANSAP, and the private and the public nurses so that we can make them address na all these issues, not only the exam, but also yung sinasabi niya, life-work balance, other reasons to motivate them to stay and fight the brain drain of Filipino nurses.
The Philippine Nurses Association welcomes the plan, hoping that it will give voice to the profession and shine a light on issues such as wages, working condition, nurse migration, and job security.
Sana hindi hanggang doon lang, kundi syempre ang kagaya ng nasabi namin sa nakaraang weeks na ang gusto namin ay yung konkretong hakbang at aksyon na dahil napakatagal na itong mga problema at usapin ng mga nurses.
The group Filipino Nurses United is hoping it will also be given a voice. FNU calls for long-term solutions to long-standing problems such as low wages and lack of job security. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Health Department assures Filipinos receiving antiretroviral drugs there is no shortage of these medicines. This comes after a group of Filipinos living with HIV raised concerns over unstable supply. Jeffrey Arnaez gives us the details.
These are antiretroviral pills, or ARB, probably the most important medicine ever discovered for people living with human immunodeficiency virus, or HIV. The drug does not eliminate the virus, but stops it from multiplying, allowing those living with HIV to lead a normal life. But the PLHIV community in the Philippines is raising the alarm, saying the supply of the life-saving medicine is dwindling.
There was a time in, sometime in May, na nagsimula ng magbigay ng 1 month na lang. So, nakaka-trigger siya, no? Nag-aalala yung mga community, ang mga client mismo. Bakit 1 month na lang yung ibinibigay? Ang problema ay, hindi malinaw yung sagot ng doktor o ng treatment hub. Whether meron bang stock out or meron bang shortage. Ang isang malinaw lang na sinabi ay, padating pa lang kasi yung manggagaling sa DOH. So yun lang yung malinaw.
The Joint United Nations Program on HIV/AIDS or UNAIDS says regular intake of ARVs is very important because it lowers and suppresses the viral load, making it undetectable in the body. Undetectable viral load means it can no longer be transmitted to their sexual partners or to an unborn child of a mother living with HIV.
If ever matigilan, even for a short amount of time, yung regular treatment of taking of the antiretroviral medication, there's a very big possibility na tataas immediately yung viral load. So what would that mean? If ever the person living with HIV does not use protection in engaging in sexual intercourse, there's a high possibility na makatransmit siya. Even if undetectable siya previously, pwede siya makatransmit ulit.
The shortage of ARVs may also lead to further increase in the number of new HIV cases. This April, the health department recorded 1,240 new cases of PLHIV, which translates to 50 new cases daily. This figure makes the Philippines the fastest growing HIV epidemic in Asia and the Pacific region.
It's beyond 200% already since 2010 yung pagdami ng cases natin. So any increase, no, as long as it still is going up, na continuous year on year, medyo alarming pa rin siya because it would point to a continuing transmission of infection, meaning ang pag-prevent natin ng pagdagdag ng new cases are not effective.
Under the HIV and AIDS Policy Act, it is the government's obligation to provide PLHIV's access to quality treatment. But the health department and the Philippine National AIDS Council assure the PLHIV community that there is no reason to worry. The health department says that the low stocks of ARVs could be attributed to unprecedented increase in the use of TLD.
Ang action ng DOH is madali nila itong solusyonan dahil nakakakuha sila ng mga stocks sa iba-ibang mga treatment hubs. No? So ganun ang ginagawa nila. Pero in terms of shortage, dun sa mga regular ARVs natin, wala po tayong shortage.
Dapat ma-implement natin ng maayos yung batas. Kaya kailangan makita namin talaga ano yung priority ng gobyerno. Ang inaasahan natin ay ang hindi lamang yung quality of life, yung assurance na kami ay kikilalanin ng ating gobyerno, ng lipunan na mga taong may dignidad din. At the end of the day, we can live beyond HIV.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. earlier instructed the new Health Secretary, Dr. Ted Herbosa, to prioritize programs that will help stop the increase in the number of new HIV cases in the country. Jeffrey Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
The Bureau of Corrections releases over 400 inmates. The move comes following a commission on audit report on the persistent problem of heavy congestion in Philippine jail facilities. Our very own Jeff Caparaz now joins us for more on this story. Jeff, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, good afternoon. 423 persons deprived of liberty or PDLs were freed from imprisonment today. 188 are among those released from new Bilibid prisons in Muntinlupa, 77 from Davao Prison and Penal Farm in Davao del Norte, 55 from Leyte Regional Prison in Abuyog, Leyte, 29 from San Ramon Prison and Penal Farm in Zamboanga City, 11 from Sablayan Prison and Penal Farm in Occidental Mindoro, 33 from Correctional Institute for Women in Mandaluyong City, 23 from Iwahig Prison and Penal Farm in Palawan, and 7 from Philippine Military Academy Prison Facility. Officials from Bureau of Corrections, Public Attorney's Office, Board of Pardons and Parole, and Department of Justice graced the event. BUCOR Director General Gregorio Catapang Jr. said the PDLs were released because they were either acquitted, granted parole, or their sentences have expired. 170 of the PDLs had their sentences cut short because of the Good Conduct Time Allowance or GCTA, while 121 were given parole. The others were recommended to be placed under probation and turned over for counseling. Catapang is confident that they are ready to face the world outside prison. But Catapang also appeals to the public, specifically employers, to give these PDLs a chance.
kailangan hinog na hinog. Kailangan dumaan talaga sa lahat ng reformation na modules. Chine-check out yan. Nag-a-appeal tayo na bigyan sila ng pag-asa, no? Kasi talaga namang dumaan na sila sa hirap. At karamihan kasi dyan, pag tinanong mo bakit ka pumatay, sir, drugs eh. Naka-drug ako. O ba't ka ng rape? Naka-drugs ako. So drug-related sila. So hopefully, hindi na sila maakit ulit sa drugs. Yun ang appeal namin sa kanila. Bigyan sila ng pag-asa na magbagong buhay.
Fermina, the Bucor earlier said it is planning to convert its prison into agriculture, aquatic, industrial, and food production facilities and will open these opportunities to investors. Katapang said this will lead to employment opportunities for inmates. But for now, only the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, or TESDA, has partnered with Bucor in training released PDLs. Since taking office, Katapang has overseen the release of 4,142 PDLs. This is in line with the decongestion plan of Bilibid and its closure in 2028. Fermina.
Thanks a lot. Jeff Caparas there joining us on the line.